howdy, 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 folks. I am glad to be here. How you like that picture? Just a beautiful, steamy, hot, steamy buns. All right, so it's kind of like going to the gym or just following me around in my yard doing chores because I wear these thick butt Carhartt pants, and so I got hot, steamy buns too by the end of the day. Anyway, we're going to talk about which hot dog brand is best. Okay, which brand is best to use? And you're going to be surprised at the answer. And I cover this in my free training. If you ever want to go check out the free training, go to learnhotdogs.com. And don't let the name fool you. I kind of pigeonholed myself with the name learnhotdogs.com because, honestly, the learnhotdogs.com, I cover all sorts of vending, from ice cream vending to ice cream bikes to elephant ears to fried pies to donuts to lemonade to kettle corn, you name it, I've got it. Check that out. Ken Packer's in the house. Thanks for being here, Ken. I'm going to turn on my camera here in just a second as soon as I can find out where it is. And I want to welcome you and thank you for being here. And I'm going to go through this quickly. I'm going to try to keep this as short as possible. And then, because I've gotten a lot of questions submitted lately, and I don't want you to think I've ignored you. It's my busiest time of year, and so I have been just slam covered up. Let me turn that off real quick. All right, look at me. I'm wearing my daughter. She works for a company that does air filters, and that's their logo. A beautiful morning here in the mountains, and I want to talk to you about the picking out the right dog to use, okay? Because a lot of people go, oh my gosh, you know, these vendors have to know, and so I get calls and emails and, you know, smoke signals, which hot dog is best to use. Now, some people already know what they're going to use, and I'm going to go through some of the basics on this, and this will be short and sweet, okay? So don't worry. This isn't a hard decision. So here's the simplest, quickest way to pick brands, okay? But it is not my favorite way, but if somebody says, I need to know today, I need to know right now, I tell them this, go to the grocery store, go to two grocery stores, maybe three. Find what they have the most of. Like if I go to my Ingles grocery store, that grocery store is going to have mostly Boar's Head, and their second most is Oscar Mayer. So I could go with Boar's Head or Oscar Mayer, and depending on my demographic, and what I mean by that is the average incomes around my area, I'm going to choose either Boar's Head or Oscar Mayer. Well, I look at both, and I go, okay, is it Oscar Mayer all beef, or is it Oscar Mayer just, you know, chicken peckers and beaks dogs? Which one is it? And then I notice that it's mostly all beef. And I go, okay, I'm going to serve an all-beef dog. That's a given. And then I'm going to go, okay, what's my demographic? My demographic ain't paying $7.50 for a freaking hot dog. See, I almost cussed there. I love that word, by the way. But anyway, they can't afford it. My demographic can't afford that. So I need to be at the $3 or $4 a hot dog. Well, what can I pull that off with? I can pull that off with a really good, nice, all-beef dog or a premium dog from Oscar Mayer. Now, if it would have been ballpark, I would have chosen ballpark. That's the quick, easy way. But I don't like the quick, easy way. I like to do my due diligence. So here's the due diligence, and this doesn't take long either. Find your top brands and even your favorite. Maybe you're from New York and you go, oh my gosh, Sabrettes is the best. You gotta have a Sabrettes. Sabrettes became popular in Florida because so many northerners go to Florida, you know, snowbirds. They go to Florida to get out of the winter, to escape the winter, and they bring their hot dogs with them. And so Sabrettes is common in Florida, and it's not a Florida dog, okay? It's not a common name anywhere but Florida and the New England states, some of the New England states. So, but Sabrette is a good hot dog. But try that Sabrette in Tennessee, and people will look at you like, Sabrette? What is that, some generic hot dog? You know, then you got to educate people. I don't want to have to educate my customer before they'll buy a hot dog. I don't want to have to go through, oh, Vienna, you should see the factory. I went to Chicago and I did a tour and it was awesome. The ingredients, oh my gosh, you'll love it. I don't want to have to educate them. I've talked about this before. Vienna, to me, growing up, meant those little mushy sausages in a can that I used to eat on camping trips and even now, right? Or potted meat, Vienna potted meat. I love freaking Vienna. Potted meats and mushy dogs. But I had never heard of a Vienna hot dog. So when I tried it and toured the factory and everything, and I was like, oh my gosh, I got to bring this to Tennessee. I brought Vienna hot dogs to Tennessee, and people were like, I ain't wanting that. I ain't eating that. I ain't having no mushy hot dog on my bun. You know, because they just didn't, they thought Vienna was the cans just like me. I was having to educate. That lasted about 3 weeks and I quit, okay? So here's what I would do. I'd go to your grocery store, or if you already know, okay, Oscar Mayer Ballpark, Nathan's is popular here because we got a Sam's Club, or we got a Walmart that has a Nathan's grill in it, or whatever it is. And you pick 5 or 6 brands that you want to serve. And then you have a gathering at your house and you do a taste test. Now, let me give you the quick, simple, easy answer on a taste test. The best way to do a taste test is with no condiments. Now, some people won't eat a hot dog without any condiments, so you have to try to convince them to do minimal condiments. That way they get the flavor, they get the texture, they get the whole package, right? Then you can actually tell what that is. If you dump 4 cups of sriracha on any hot dog, they all taste the same, right? So you want them to limit their condiments. Now, what I did is I cut up my hot dogs. I'd put a hot dog in a bun, okay, let's say Nathan's, and I'd put it in the bun, and then I took blue toothpicks, and I stuck it down the bun into the dog, okay, about 4 of them. And then I cut them into fourths. So I took one hot dog and turned it into 4 bite-sized sections. You can do 4 or 5. Then I did the same with other brands, but then I also gave them a toothpick color. So if I did Oscar Mayer, it was red. If I did Lay's, we have a brand called Lay's, which is a popular brand here. We did, I did red, and then I just did different color toothpicks. Well, I didn't tell my consumer, my friends and family, what those dog brands were. I just said, here you go, try it. Tell me which one you like best. And they tried them. And some of them wanted 2 or 3 samples of the same thing, kind of, okay, this sounds pretty good, this feels pretty good. And so they tested them. So that's what we did to start. And what I ended up with is 2 that were very popular, Oscar Mayer and Nathan's. So I chose the Nathan's. Well, Nathan's was expensive. Okay, to me, it was expensive. And I was like, that's too expensive. So what I did is I found out that Sam's Club has an off-brand that made Nathan's at the time. At least that's what the manager told me. He goes, our Sam's, it was called the, I can't think of it now, but either way, it was their Sam's Choice or whatever. It was a Nathan's hot dog, is what I was told by the manager. So I started serving it, and everybody loved it. Well, then I got to learning that I could flavor my water. So I could take a pretty bland hot dog, your average Piggly Wiggly discount meat section brand, okay? No label on it, and I could put it in water that I had pre-seasoned. So basically, I took my water in my cart, and I dumped in some seasonings, any seasonings you want. I put whole garlic cloves or partially crushed garlic cloves and maybe some McCormick seasoning and maybe some beer. I used to use beer in mine, just an old beer. Dump it in there. And what you got is a different flavor of that dog. And it did well. So we've got vendors now that are using their own made up brand of hot dogs. So they'll buy some generic brand and then jack it up for the consumer. Now, you can get all fancy and start injecting your dogs with some kind of secret sauce that you've created. Not worth it to me. If you're going to do any kind of volume, not worth it. Just buy a good premium hot dog. Now, there are areas, let me tell you, where a chicken beacon pecker dog is better or more common and more liked than in than an all beef dog. Let me give you an example. Y'all seen me film with Frankenstein's. His best-selling hot dog is a chicken beacon pecker dog. And what I'm talking about is those ones you buy that say, made from chicken piece parts, pork piece parts, and cow piece parts. Okay? So that's a mixed meat, it's a minced meat dog, right? But they're good. My wife thinks they're the best. That's all she wants. She doesn't want an all-beef dog. Some people like the all-beef. Then you start getting into the casings. Do you want a natural casing, no casing, synthetic casing? Let me tell you, this really comes down to personal opinions. It's like buttholes, everybody's got one, you pick one, okay? If your area is used to, oh, if it's always marketed in your area that, hey, Vienna's all premium natural casing. Okay, that's pig intestines, and most people don't realize that, but that's a natural casing. And so they use the intestine to wrap the hot dog in, or sausage. And so some people like that because it has a snap. You'll hear people in the New England states talk about the snap of the dog. I want to feel that snap. I mean, they're like anal retentive about that snap. I could care less, right? I do prefer an all-beef dog, but most of the people in my area really just want a hot dog. They really don't care. So I figured I could buy cheaper brands, still give a good quality dog, and I'd jack up the flavor and make it my own. I'd call it my own. I interviewed Hot Dog Mike, and he said, people come up to him and go, what brand are you serving? And he goes, oh, this is the Hot Dog Mike brand. It's Hot Dog Mike. It's my brand, because it is. It's his brand. So that's it. In a nutshell, that's how you determine what to serve on a hot dog cart, okay? So you've got your quick, easy answer. Go to the grocery store. What are they selling the most of? They keep up with statistics of what they sell the most of, and what they stock the most of is how you can tell what they sell the most of. So whatever's displaying the most of is their top brand, and they have tried many, okay? So you have to look at that. You have to look at demographics. You have to go, okay, well, this has, you know, wine Chablis sauce in it, infused in it, and it's aged pork, whatever. And you go, yeah, but it's $19 a hot dog. Well, my area won't do that. I'm not in Beverly Hills. So you have to look at those things. I want to say howdy to everybody. I thank you for all your comments and stuff. If I missed any of your questions, comments, or anything, please email me, ben@vendorsunited.com. ben@vendorsunited.com. Remember, I put some top 40 questions and the top 10 questions I get asked daily, right down below in the comments, in the description, and then the top 40 new vendor questions asked over the last 9.5 years. And maybe one of those is your question. Odds are they are. But if you have a question anyway, send it to me, and I'll try to do a video or do something or answer it or send you a link to the answer I've already done. Either way, I love you. I wish you well. This is a phenomenal season, a phenomenal time to be vending. There is tons of vendors vending. I just released this morning a video that I did. I got the privilege of doing with Keith and Corey. And if y'all don't know them, you ain't been following me long. Corey's with O'Doggies. Keith is, I don't know who he's with. He's with Mary. And they have, anyway, you'll see it on the channel. It's an app where it makes you more money, makes you money while you sleep. You don't download nothing. Your customer doesn't download nothing. It's just a easy way to have another employee for about $2.50 a day. It is phenomenal, and you should see. I have an interview scheduled again today for 2 p.m. this lady has did over, I believe, 2,200 last month in sales that came automatically while she's sleeping. You should see that. That video is here somewhere on the YouTube channel. I just released it this morning. So grab that. It's a long video, okay, but it's a long interview process. But it's worth your time. You don't have to watch it. You can just listen to it. Because Keith's on there, and it's not even easy on the eyes anyway. Anyway, I wish you well. I hope y'all have a great day. Holler at me anytime, and I'll do my best to help you out. And you'll love this. You'll love the business. You probably already do if you're already in it. It's an awesome business. I'll talk to you soon, and I'll be back soon.